All right, album 4.
Is it my turn?
Yeah.
Your turn. No, because I just did K.O.D.
Yeah, the K.O.D., yeah. Cardi B, Invasion of Privacy.
Okay.
Well, I mean, for me, it's the same kind of thing with Migos. I just had a lot of fun. But it's just like with a female voice.
Mm-hmm.
And like, I love some of the clever lyric choices she had. For example, on the song, I Like It, eating halal, driving a lamb. It's just a pretty cool lyric. And like the Beacon Head is pretty nasty. The Burak Yellow and Be Careful. I love the way that she spiced it up with like different genres of music even a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like she had some soulful track like Be Careful or the Through Your Phone. And the rap songs, what makes it most enjoyable for me, like the Bartier Cardi, or I Like It, or Burak Yellow, or the Drip song with Migos.
Mm.
Yeah, I just really love the album. Oh, and the intro, Get Up 10, when it came in, when I just clicked like play on the album, it's just like, damn, like she really spits some true fire. Like the lyrics were pretty good. It was unexpected.
Mm.
She came in really strong, and then it sets the tone for the album, and the album delivers.
I also enjoyed that album. Not so much to add to my list.
Mm-hmm.
Problem I had with that album was that Cardi B, I liked her singles a lot, Bartier Cardi and what's it called?
Burak Yellow.
Yeah, I love those singles.
Mm-hmm.
Like her flow is so interesting. But then Be Careful, I didn't like.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it was just too generic for me. And then once the album came out, I was pretty excited to listen to it because like, what else can she offer?
Yeah.
Like, if her third single is so mediocre, like does she really have that much more to offer?
Mm-hmm.
For me personally, the album, the best tracks were made by features.
Mm.
For me.
Mm-hmm.
My favorite tracks off of that album are the Chance the Rapper track.
Oh yeah, that's like.
And Ring with Kalani.
Mm.
Cause the chord ring. I love
that. Yeah, it's pretty good.
But just like the fact that Cardi B herself, I didn't enjoy that much.
Mm-hmm.
Cause I feel like she kind of got stale, her flow got a little bit stale after how many songs were in 13
yeah.
songs. Just the rap flow to me didn't stay interesting.
Mm.
But when the features came in, it was like enough to make the song good.
Mm.
Because there was a little bit of variety.
Yeah.
But from her, because like that interesting flow that she had kind of went away.
Mm-hmm.
To me, the album wasn't top 10 material just because she didn't make the album good. Some other people made that.
I see. Yeah.
And she's better as a feature than.
True. And I want to add like last thing about this album. When I was, I think I was listening to Yeezus when I was like driving to college, and I was like, you know, there are just dark songs, right? Like I was like closed my windows, like and like put the volume up high,
yes.
Put the air conditioner. And I was listening, Black Skinhead, and then like I Am a God, and like and I was singing along, like in my mood, like dark mood, and then like I opened the door. I opened the window. I was in the headlight, like this red light, and then I look next car and I see some like four females. They're just blasting the song Best Life and they're like having fun with
yeah,
it.
Best Life. Okay.
Yeah, and I just love the fact that, you know, hey, like I felt like at that moment I could see like females really enjoying this album because. Like, we have a lot of rap albums, but like, not many female rap albums. And like, for them, it's like, oh, like, this is a treasure, to be honest.
It is,
like,
it is a message, like a female empowerment.
Yeah.
I mean, it's, yeah, she's a good rapper.
Yeah.
She is, she really is a good rapper.
Yeah, it was pretty good to see that.
Mm. Okay.
And album 3? Your turn, right?
4.
Oh, 4, my bad.
4 for me is Now The Weeknd, My Dear Melancholy.
Okay.
Because obviously, I mean, I have a different history with The Weeknd than you do. My first intro to The Weeknd was off Take Care.
Uh-huh.
Which is probably one of my favorite albums ever.
Mm-hmm.
But, and I didn't really know.
Take Care by Drake.
By Drake,
just
yeah.
Noticed it, yeah.
What are they Take Care?
I mean,
maybe there's another
don't
Take Care.
I mean,
Take Care
they
by
don't know?
Some,
like,
I don't know.
Yeah.
But Drake, Take Care.
Mm-hmm.
Probably best of Drake for me and also best in general. But that song, I mean, I didn't even know who it was, The Weeknd, but I love
mm-hmm.
that song.
Yeah.
Crew
Love, did you mention
Crew Love? Yeah. I don't know where it was at. But And he pretty much, apparently he pretty much wrote that whole album. Like, it was songs off of his trilogy, or House of Balloons, and he gave it to Drake because they were, like, having a partnership or whatever.
Yeah.
But that's what he says. I don't know if it's true, but I'm just going off of that. But, and then I had, there was a song, Love Me Harder, with Ariana Grande. And then, what's it called? Fifty Shades, earned it. And then that song was like cemented, and it got me so into it. And that album, Beauty Behind the Madness, was just like my album for so long. But now I'm like obsessed with The Weeknd. But so when this album came out, when he just fucking, he's like, hey, I don't care if you want to drop it, you can drop it. Just drop it this Friday. I was like, okay, Weeknd, all right, I'm able, like. Okay, and then he dropped it. It's only six songs, going back obviously to, like you said, like the trilogy, kind of the setup. And I was like, and I'm assuming he's gonna do the three albums. And it has the comma at the end, so it's like, let's keep going. Just like, it's the Weeknd, dude.
Yeah.
It's the Weeknd. He kind of tried something new with Starboy, which a lot of people didn't like, actually. But I mean, it became, it was like pop, it's popularized at this point. It's more of a pop album than his dark shit that probably wouldn't be on the radio. But and this album, I feel like, is the best parts of Starboy, but it's darker.
Yes.
It's darker and it sounds amazing. And just like, you can just listen to it and be depressed.
Yeah.
And just like let it like take your soul and just like take it on a journey. Like,
yeah.
That's what that album is for me. And I'm hoping that more will come after the comma. And there will be two more six song albums, and it'll be another trilogy, and all his fans will be happy, and everyone will be happy.
For sure.
The world will be happy.
Yeah.
That's it.
Album three. We have. Oh shit. what do I have? Album three. Oh shit, I think you're not gonna enjoy that pick, but Logic Boy by Tarantino 2. Because, well, the reason is so high because I listened to it a lot. That's it, pretty much. I listened to it like, what, 2 months, I believe? Because I felt like, for me, it's the best Logic album for sure. And also the way the rapping was just too good, like the beats were just on, like, so good as well. It felt like Logic was really on fire, like he was going in this whole project. And like, we listened to it with my friend AJ when we were kind of going to your university as well. And he himself, like, he haven't heard Logic. Maybe just a couple of tracks. He really enjoyed that album. He then listened himself after. Like, I could see it on his Apple Music. Like, I'm with him and friends on there, and yeah, we both enjoyed it. Crystal, other friends.
Chris loves it.
Yeah, loves it too. Just great project.
I personally, I was kind of a fan of Logic. I got into Logic because of John Bellion, because they're both Visionary Music Group, and then when he dropped, what's that album? Everybody? What's that?
Yeah,
it's called Everybody. When he dropped that, I really liked it. I didn't like, but the problem I had with that album was there were so many bits, like skits in the middle, that I couldn't listen to it as an album because I'd get bored once I'm repeating it. Like, I don't want to hear him talking every single time I listen. But there were some songs over there I picked out. And then when this came out as a mixtape, I was pretty excited. And when it came out, I thought it was great. I was like, damn, like, he's got the flow, it's fire. Like, it's Logic, like Logic, how he works. But as I listen, I'm kind of tired of Logic flow in general. Like, the way that he raps, it's gifted, it's fast, it's crazy, but for me, as a, when I listen over and over, it's kind of like, okay, I get it. Like, you're really good, you're fast, but I don't want to listen anymore. I'm done, like, I understand.
Okay,
it's cool, but yeah, I wouldn't put it on the list. There are some songs I like off of it, but not like top 10 material.
Okay.
My number three is RIP XXX's, question mark. Although I personally like what was it called,
the 17,
I like that a lot more because first of all, it was shorter, it was more concise, and like the sound is a lot darker, and like, and I really like that kind of sound. But this album had a little bit of that, but he made it a little bit longer, he had a couple of questionable songs in there, like
The Spanish one.
The Spanish one wasn't that bad. I actually enjoyed the Spanish one. His part sucked.
Yeah.
He should have stayed on that track, but the beginning was pretty nice. But there's that one song, I don't remember what the guy is, like, called Dollar Sign or some shit like that. Okay. Hated that song. It's just ridiculous. Like, it's just, like, so unprofessional for what he was, the message he's trying to send. Like, he has so many good songs. Like, nice, good production, like, sending, like, a kind of message, like, change and sad, I guess. I kind of not really a fan of that song, but I understand, like, the way, the thing that he's trying to say. And, Why Am I So In Love, stuff like that. I really like that sound. The album was a little long, a little bloated. Like, some of the songs were kind of, like, skippable. And Moonlight was insane. Like, the production on that, and just, like, so much potential he had. R.I.P. But that album, just like the few songs on there, majority of the songs on there that I really like, and the song with Joey Badass.
Oh yeah, that was.
Oh
yeah, yeah.
That was all insane. Of that, just like, and the flows, and just he's just having fun with it a little bit.
Yeah.
But it still sounds really good.
Mm-hmm.
Just that feeling makes it for me top three of this half of the year. And I'm sad that he had two more albums coming out this year. I'm sad we're not going to be able to listen to them in the complete form. But I'm glad that we did get that one album before.
Yeah. Well, to be honest, I'm not actually a fan, and I wasn't into his music at all. But I, of course, can see why so many people were into him. I mean, they still are, but...
Even more than, I guess, than before.
Yeah, because, like, after his death, the streams rocketed up high in the charts, but... I don't know, it's just probably not my taste.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense. I mean, I don't like mumble rap, you don't like... We all like different things.
Yeah. What do we have now? Oh, album two.
Two.
Already. Yeah, okay. Well... Not hard to guess, it's gonna be by Kanye West. Kids See Ghosts. With Kid Cudi. I really enjoyed that project. It's really experimental. I just love the fact that Kanye West is back again. As you mentioned on Ye, what did you mention? Just kidding. Well, you mentioned that we're waiting for it a long time, and we're glad that he delivered great music. Really concise, really consistent. It stays well throughout the whole thing. I just love the fact that there is no fillers at all. And Kid Cudi, I really like him too, and I was really glad that he had a great time making this music, because you could feel that Kid Cudi, like, delivering one of the best materials he had in a long time, and just they both made magic on this songs, and I really love that it happened. And that's pretty much it.
Yeah. I personally, I'm not the biggest fan of this album. I've told Bob before. It kind of reminds me of my Beautiful Dark Fantasy, that kind of vibe.
Yeah.
But, and I mean, I always go back to that album and I try to enjoy it.
Because a lot of people
tell me that I should like it.
Because
and maybe I'm wrong. But then I go back and I just can't. Like,
you should just watch the videos.
Yeah, I guess.
It's,
but like,
it's,
I feel like the video will not make me enjoy the song. Maybe I'll enjoy the video, but I won't enjoy it.
Because
I've tried. Like, I tried recently, even a couple weeks ago. I tried because my friend from university was like, I can't believe you don't like this, so why don't you like this album? Like, it's such a great album. And I'm like, okay, I'll go and listen again. But I just, the way the kind of style of it tires me out. Like, when I'm listening, like, I get bored of the songs. And I'm like, it's like, okay, I get it. He's a genius. Like, he's trying to, like, give so much information out and give, like, this extravagant production in the song. But just, to me, it goes too much, and it's just like, not enjoyable listen. There's a couple songs I like on there because of the sample. Fourth Dimension I really like. And there's that other song, I forgot what it's called.
Reborn?
I don't remember. I think it's like right after or something. Maybe not. I don't know. I don't remember. There's another song there.
My bad.
I don't know what the song is called. But there's a couple good songs I like on there, but in general, as a total album, I skip it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I won't I wouldn't listen to it.
Yeah.
By choice. If it was there, I'll listen to it. I'll be like, yeah, it's funny, whatever. But I wouldn't put it on myself.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I just want to add the fact that My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy is my favorite album of all time.
Yeah. Well, kind of like, I'm like, why do I like it?
But yeah. What do you have for it's like number two?
Number two is, I don't know, I don't even know if you gave this a listen, but Panic at the Disco.
Oh, I never did.
Friend of the Wicked.
Yeah, I haven't listened to it.
Yeah, it just came out 2 weeks ago now, mm-hmm. so it barely made it in to the first half of the year, but wow. Like, people, I don't know if people know this, but Panic at the Disco was a band, now it's one person.
Really?
Now it's just Brendan Urie. Like, he does everything. He produces himself, he does all the vocals, he does all the instruments.
Wait, what happened though?
They broke up. Like, two people left after the second album because of creative differences.
Mm-hmm.
And then the third guy had drug issues. So he left. So now it's literally him. He is Panic at the Disco. His first self-produced album was Death of the Bachelor,
mm-hmm.
which was an okay album. It wasn't, it had a couple of really good singles, but as a general album, I thoughts on a lot of it was skippable.
So you said the Death of the Bachelor is an album, it's the first album he was
the only one. Yeah.
Uh-huh, okay.
At that point he was the last, like before that he still had two members,
mm-hmm.
but after that he was the only one. That album was the first one where it was just him.
Okay.
This album is his second attempt,
mm-hmm.
and it's just so many bounds ahead of the first one.
Mm.
It's just like, it's so, the production is awesome. He loves like loud production, like trumpet production.
Mm-hmm.
Reminds kind of like Broadway-ish style sometimes.
Yeah.
But then he also goes like, he does the piano and he does the, just like, and his voice is so powerful. So he can just, and it sounds like really happy for most of the songs, but if you actually listen to it, yeah, it's actually a pretty dark album.
Mm.
Like, he talks about a lot of stuff in the industry of how pretty much, he pretty much is ironically talking from the point of view of the industry and how people are like evil and all they're doing is for money,
mm-hmm.
and like the struggles of being in Hollywood,
mm.
as an artist and how you go there and then everything that happens and then if you make it you make it, if you don't then you're screwed.
Yeah.
And just like the whole there's one song on the album I don't like. It's called Overpass. It's okay. It's like, it's kind of like loud, but I don't really like how it sounds.
I'm just taking notes.
So he's gonna go listen to it later.
Yeah.
But just like everything he puts into it, and the fact that he's the only one that worked. Like, he does everything.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that that is a thing, and he's come up with this product is just unbelievable.
Mm.
And I can listen to it probably for like the next 2 months.
That's good.
And it's great. I love it all.
And we've come to number one.
For you.
Yeah.
You want to give honorable mention to
Yeah.
I mean, I kind of want to give a little bit of props to Drake Scorpion. It came out
just,
it is
now
in the first half of the year, like the last day of the first half,
yeah.
of the year. I mean, I guess June, whatever, don't worry about it.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, we kind of reviewed it, but we were fucking around and we didn't really give it a good listen.
Yeah.
And I've been listening to it since then and I love it. Like, I think there's 2-3 songs on the album I don't like out of 25. Like, that's fucking insane.
Yeah.
How do you make 22 songs that are enjoyable in one album? And it's just like talking, the things he talks about, and like, just the sound, the R&B sound is just enjoyable to listen to.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like just because it was so late, I can't put it in my top 10 because I kind of had this prepared before we listened to that. And but honorable mention, it's amazing. It's a good album. The things I said in that video, if you watched it, don't worry about it. Erase it from your mind. It was stupid. But yeah.
For me, I think Drake Scorpion, he still gotta grow on me. To be honest, like, you had a lot of time, like, probably to listen to this. I was all over the place. I probably just listened to it once or twice. I don't think that I have listened to all 25 tracks, to be honest. But the takeaways from me were 16 tracks, which is still great. Like, I added like 16 tracks to my playlist. I mean, like, the way you craft your playlist is different than mine. Mine is just like summer 2018 right now. The songs I would listen to right now, right? Like, and out of 25, I guess like 9 songs just didn't really stick with me, but 16 did. So it's pretty good still. I don't know about the top 10, to be honest. I still gotta just give it a listen more, because for me right now, I don't feel attached to the album. Like it's not Nothing Was the Same, it's not Take Care, it's not even like More Life, because in More Life I enjoyed it a lot, even though it's 22 songs. It just feels different for me right now, still. Like, feels like I'm just not into Drake that much right now.
Yeah.
But maybe it will change.
Okay.
And
number one.
Yeah, Kanye West. Yay.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't have anything else to say. You said really good points about it. I just love the fact that he was bold enough to like admit that like there are some issues with mental health, and like when he does crazy things, he kind of implements them into the album. Like he screams sometimes,
yeah,
with the yikes, like I'm a superhero because I have a disability, but it's because of that, actually, like it's my power, it's not my weakness. And I love that aspect though. When he's screaming like, yeah, like at the end, I scream with him. It's kind of just fun to listen. And then All Mine, the track All Mine, I really love the fact that he has that, what do you call it? Probably the greatest lyrics of this album, to be honest. Like, they're so clever.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned about none of us would be without him in this world. Also, the Kerry Washington,
yeah,
like the scandal,
mm-hmm,
is just like, like that's why we love Kanye, because of this not only greatest production but also this clever lyrics.
Mm. Okay, yeah, I agree with what you say. But my first number one was your number 10.
Really? Shawn Mendes?
Shawn Mendes.
Wow, okay.
Shawn Mendes, self-titled.
Wow.
Fucking hell, dude.
Number one.
When I did not expect, like, I like Shawn Mendes. I'm not a huge fan of Shawn Mendes. I wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't like, oh my god, Shawn Mendes, every song. Like, yeah, he has some good songs. I like his style, but his style is a little bit like amateur,
mm-hmm,
to this point.
Mm.
But this album, wow, like the sound and the variety of sound,
uh-huh,
and just the writing and like every song on here. The only song I kind of dislike is the one with Julia Michaels,
mm-hmm,
but even that is a good song. Like,
yeah, I love it.
I wouldn't like, yeah, it's amazing. Like, it just sounds nice to listen to,
mm-hmm,
and the way like it feels like he's matured. Like the things he talks about are kind of the same,
mm-hmm,
but also in a more mature way than his like high school-y. Like, he's still what, 20?
23 maybe? Oh, no, yeah, you're right, 21.
I think, yeah, he's young.
Yeah.
He's not even old enough to drink here. Like, I remember reading some some article about how he only drinks in Canada because he can't drink. But, so he's not even 21.
Okay.
But he's just, it feels like so much more mature, and just like the way his songs are structured is,
mm-hmm,
so much more mature, and just like the variety. I feel like if you go back and listen to like Handwritten or Illuminate, I think it's called.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's kind of like, if you keep listening, you kind of hear the same things,
mm-hmm,
the same styles of guitar. Like, I like it, but it's not something completely out of mind blowing. But once you get here, there's still that guitar, but there's like an additional,
yeah,
thing on top of it.
Mm-hmm.
And just the writing, and of course Ed Sheeran is on one song, which I loved, In the Morning. And then Khalid's on the song.
Yeah.
And his voice has always been amazing. Like, he has a like, good voice to listen to. And
you're talking about Khalid, right?
Or Khalid, yeah, but Shawn Mendes as well.
Okay.
But and then his work, the fact that when he adds to the guitar and the production on top of the guitar, it really makes it like a good sound to listen to every song. And it's different, and every song is a different way, like a utilization of what he has,
mm-hmm,
to offer. And he has a lot, like his versatility of his vocals is also there.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's not just like the same thing over and over, like Mercy. I feel like Mercy and Treat You Better are kind of, the way he sings is very similar.
Mm-hmm.
But once it comes here, every song has like a kind of a different style.
Mm-hmm.
And it keeps you in the album.
Yeah.
And it's not a short album, I think it's 14 songs. But it's not that, I mean, it's not Drake Scorpion level, but it's not a short album. But it, never in the album was I like, damn, I hate this. Mm-hmm. Or like, damn, I just want to skip this song. Because it's just, and I listened to it maybe for, I've been listening to it since it came out, May 20 something.
Yeah.
And it's still, I'm not tired of it yet. Mm-hmm. It's just, the style, just it just gets me. It's there.
That's great. because of this, like, unexpected, like, pick from you, like, I didn't expect that, like, that's why we decided to not reveal the list beforehand before recording this video, and I really loved the way we did it. All right, well, that was the top 10 list favorite albums of the first half of the year.
It's a fucking podcast, bro.
Yeah.
Oh my god, almost it's like an hour.
But I mean, hopefully somebody will make it through like the end of the video. No, we really had a lot of fun recording this video and talking about music.
And our passion. If you didn't stop us, we would talk for like 3 years.
Yeah.
But obviously we have a kind of a limit, even though it's an hour long of one video. But
yeah,
I mean, we want to talk about a top 10 album. Like, if there's a reason they're in our top 10 albums as music lovers, you gotta have something to say.
Yeah, true. Yeah. Alright, well, that was the video. Hit the like button if you like this video. Subscribe to this channel for sure. And we'll see you guys in the next video, so hopefully. Bye.
Peace out.